So far, we've seen two aggregation operators, group and sort. There are several others in addition to these two. I'm going to go through each one briefly to explain how it works. I'll just summarize them here. Later, we'll dig into each one individually, and I'll show you what it does. All right, so the first operator we'll look at is project. I put together some dummy data here that we can use as we talk about each one of these operators. Now, the project operator allows you to shape documents it receives as input into what you need for the next stage. The simplest form of shaping is using project to select which fields you're interested in exactly, like we did in the last lesson when projecting out the motto for cities and other single fields we were interested in looking at. So for example here, if in the documents I received to my stage in which I'm using a project operator, I'm interested, say, in this field, and perhaps this one as well, then I can use a project operator to simply pull out these individual values, regardless of where they're nested in the input documents, and project them out in documents into the next stage of the pipeline, or the result if I'm at the end of the pipeline. We'll look at the syntax for project a little bit later. Essentially with project, I can take the fields I receive in an individual document and perform a number of different types of operations on them in order to produce documents for the next stage of the pipeline. Select is one. I could also say, for example, as we'll look at later, produce a ratio based on two numeric fields and create a new field that will then be passed on in documents to the next stage of the pipeline. The next operator I want to look at is match. Match filters documents. So for example, I might set up some match criteria that would cause me to end up filtering so that I only ended up with this document and this document from the documents I was passed as input to my aggregation stage using the match operator. I can, of course, also group and sort. And we looked at a pretty detailed example for both of these, so I won't go into further detail here. So the next operator I'd like to cover is skip. Skip is designed to allow us to simply skip over a certain number of documents at the beginning of our input set of documents to the aggregation stage using skip. So for example, if I wanted to skip the first three input documents, then the first document I would output would be this one and all documents following it. Limit kind of does the reverse of skip. So in this case, if I limited what I was passing on to the next stage of the pipeline to three documents, then what I would be doing is simply taking those three documents and filtering out everything else.